डियर चिल्ड्रन,
वेलकम टू द ऑनलाइन साइंस क्लास।
माय डियर चिल्ड्रन, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप यू आर फाइन एंड यू आर सेफ। यू आर डूइंग योर वर्क्स वेरी गुड। देन हैव यू हैड योर ब्रेकफास्ट? यस। देन व्हाट स्पेशल फॉर योर ब्रेकफास्ट? डोसा, इडली, इडियाप्पम, so many types of breakfast are there. Okay, my dear children, do you understand what we have learned in our previous classes? We have started learning our chapter 6, importance of vitamins and minerals, right? So do you understand up to page number 109? Take your textbook along with you, take a pencil with you and listen the class. Okay, shall I start the class? Okay, before entering into the class, I need to ask some questions. Okay, so which vitamin we get from sunlight? Vitamin D. So many types of minerals we have, vitamins we have learned. So what are the vitamins are there? Vitamin A, vitamin D, vitamin E, vitamin K, vitamin B1, B2, B3, B6, B12, K. Okay, so today we are going to learn about the minerals. Okay, today we are going to learn about minerals. So what are the minerals out there in our body? Okay, it is essential for our body, needed by the body. So what are they? Calcium, iodine, phosphorus and iron. What are they? Calcium, iodine, phosphorus and iron. Okay, so minerals will keep our body very healthy. Okay, minerals will keep our body very healthy. Okay, strengthen our bone and maintain a normal heartbeat. Okay, our minerals will help to strengthen our bones and to maintain a correct heartbeat. Okay, so what are the important function of bones are? Formation of bone. What are the important functions of mineral? First one, formation of bone. Okay, it helps to formation of bone, teeth and blood cells. Okay, formation of bone, teeth and blood cells. So what are the sources of minerals? Milk, meat, fish, air, fruits and vegetable. What are they? Milk, meat, fish, eggs, fruits and vegetable. Do you understand up to this much? Yes. Okay, my dear children, so minerals are classified into two types. Okay, totally minerals are classified into two types. What are they? Macro minerals and trace minerals. What are they? Macro minerals and trace minerals. Okay, so now we are going to learn separately about this macro minerals and trace minerals. Okay, first one, macro minerals. In the name you can understand, it is needed in large quantity. Micro means very small, macro means it is very large. Okay, macro minerals are needed by in large quantity. Okay, it's needed by our body in large quantity. So what are the example? Calcium, magnesium, sodium and potassium. What are they? Calcium, magnesium, sodium and potassium. While compared with trace minerals, macro minerals are needed by the body in high large quantities. Okay, in large quantity it is needed by our body. Then trace minerals. Trace minerals are needed by the body in small quantity. Okay, in small quantity it is needed by the body. So what are the examples? Iron, zinc, copper and iodine. What are they? Iron, zinc, copper and iodine. Now, okay, my dear children, are you listening? Can you able to hear my voice? Okay, my dear children. So, what are the two types of minerals? Macro minerals and trace minerals. So, what is macro minerals? Macro minerals are needed by the body in large quantity. So, what are the example? Calcium, magnesium, sodium, and potassium. Okay. Then, what is trace mineral? Trace minerals is needed by a body in very small quantity. Okay. So, what are the example? Iron, zinc, copper, and iodine. Okay. So, we shall move to the next one. Okay. So, below a tabular column is given, right? So, it denotes, okay, what are the minerals contained in this food? So, milk, okay, milk, our dairy product like milk, cheese, okay, it contains calcium. What is present in milk? Calcium, okay. Then, green leafy vegetable, spinach, broccoli, okay, spinach, broccoli, it contains iron. What is present in this? Iron. Then salt contain iodine is present in salt. Okay. Then citrus fruits, orange, lemon contain potassium. Orange and lemon contain potassium. Then fish is rich in iodine and magnesium. Do you understand? So milk contain calcium, green leafy vegetable contain iron, salt contain iodine, orange contain potassium, and fish contain iodine and magnesium. Okay, we move to the next one. Deficiency of minerals. If there is a lack of minerals in our body, there are some diseases will affect our body. Okay, important minerals. Okay, the upcoming PPT contain important minerals, where they get from and what are the deficiency disease will get from the mineral. Okay, so there are certain chemicals. Okay, our minerals will assist a certain chemical reaction of the body. So, cooking will not destroy them. Okay, cooking does not destroy them. So, see my dear children, this is the chart. Okay, so what the name of the mineral, where they get from source, and what are the function, and what are the deficiency disease caused. First one, calcium. Okay, so calcium is present in milk, green leafy vegetables also contain calcium. So, what are the function? It strengthens the bones and teeth. Calcium is essential for our bone and teeth. Okay. And then it helps in the clotting of blood. Okay. Our blood need to clot when there is a cut. Okay. So, it helps in the clotting of blood. Then next one. What's the deficiency disease? Osteoporosis. Okay. Osteoporosis. So, what do you mean by osteoporosis? They know the person who is affected by osteoporosis have very weak bone. Okay, very weak bone, and it is easily broken. The bones can be easily broken. Usually, this disease will affect the adult people. Okay, adult people are affected by osteoporosis. Then rickets is also one of the deficiency disease. Excessive bleeding. If there is any cut in our body, it will bleed excessively. Okay. The next one, potassium. Okay, next one is potassium. Salt, banana and citrus fruits. Salt contain potassium, banana contain potassium. Citrus fruits like orange, lemon contain potassium. Okay, so what are the function? It helps in maintaining our body water balance. Our body contain water, so it helps to maintain the water balance in our body. So deficiency disease, dehydration, the water level in the body become very low. Then general weakness. Okay, normally we feel some weakness in our body. Okay, the next one, magnesium. Okay, magnesium, it is present in green leafy vegetable, cereals, chicken and fish. Okay, so it regulates the functioning of muscles and nerves. Okay, it helps to regulate the functioning of muscles and nerves. Okay, then so deficiency diseases, the muscle become very weak, and there are some problems will affect the nervous system. Okay, the next one is iron. Iron is present in cereals, pulses, meat, and green leafy vegetable. What are they? Cereals, pulses, meat, and green leafy vegetables. So what are the function? It helps to form hemoglobin and blood cell. Hemoglobin is the main thing in our blood. Okay, if there is any increase or less in the hemoglobin, will affect some diseases and red blood cell. Okay, so deficiency disease, anemia, weakness. Then white nails, the nails will be very pale and it looks like white. Okay, loss of weight, our weight will be lost. Okay, the next one, iodine is present in fish and salt. Okay, so we need to take fish. Okay, required for the proper functioning of thyroid gland. Our thyroid gland is in our neck part, right? So it is very required for our proper functioning of the thyroid. The next one, goiter. What is the deficiency disease? Goiter. So what is goiter? Our neck contains thyroid gland. Two pairs of thyroid gland is in our neck part. So goiter means our neck part becomes swollen. Okay, our neck part becomes swollen because the thyroid gland get swollen. Okay, do you understand? Okay, we move to the next one. Physical exercise. We need to do exercise every day. To maintain, if you want to maintain a healthy body, we need to do physical exercise regularly. Okay, physical exercise will help our body to become very strong. Okay, it will help to increase our stamina and it helps to improve our body condition. Okay, then it also make our heartbeat fast. Okay, it helps to maintain our heartbeat fast, and so that the circulation of blood will be very good, very improved. Okay, so lack of exercise, if we have no exercise in our body, then we will gain so much weight and the muscles become very loose. Okay, then walking, jogging, swimming, cycling. Okay, these are good exercise. Walking, jogging, swimming, cycling. You can play any outdoor games also. Okay, you can play with your friends. Football, cricket, badminton. So many types of games are there. You can play the game. So, while playing, you will get exercise for your body. Or else, you can help your mom to do your household work. Okay, this also gives best exercise for you. If you have cycle in your home, you should cycle. You can cycle. Cycling, you can go cycling. This will help you to increase your health condition. Okay, so we are at the end of the lesson. We are going to recall what we have learned in our lesson. So what is the topic of the lesson? Importance of vitamins and minerals. So the vitamins and minerals contain, so what we have learned, firstly vitamins, sources and deficiency disease, minerals, and then importance of exercise. First, we have learned about vitamins, right? Vitamins are classified into two types, fat soluble vitamin and water soluble vitamin. So what are the fat soluble vitamins? Vitamin A, vitamin D, vitamin E, and vitamin K. Okay, then water soluble vitamin, vitamin B complex and vitamin C. Okay, then we have learned about the sources and the deficiency diseases. Then next we have learned about the minerals. Two types of minerals are there, macro minerals and trace minerals. So what are the macro minerals? Calcium, magnesium, sodium and potassium. Then trace minerals. So what are the trace minerals? Iron, zinc, copper and iodine. Okay, so my dear children, the students in this your class have some less cooperation with the teachers. Okay, my dear children, I want you all to cooperate with us. Okay, okay, my dear children, we are at the end of the chapter. We are going to complete our semester one. Only few students have sent their snapshot, have submit your exam papers, remaining others are not responding even for your notes also. Okay, so I want you all to respond. Okay, I want you all to work hard along with us. Okay, in the upcoming days you should respond as you are going to write your semester exam, so you need to work hard. So prepare well, be good children. Okay, so I will send the notes by this evening. You should copy it in your notebook. After that you should take a snapshot and send it to me. Those who didn't send the snapshot, I will call you and I will ask the reason for your work. Okay, I will reason, I need your reason why you are not sending the snapshot. Okay, okay, my dear children, I hope you will all send your snapshot along with your name. You should send along with your name. Okay, okay, take care, bye bye, we will meet in the next class. Thank you.